In this learning module, we will consider the ways in which graphical tables may be used to visualize data, including the display of spark lines, calculated values, icons, and bullet graphs. The graphical table visualization allows you to organize these informational elements for categorical items which are organized as rows in a table. For example, the graphical table can be used to display information for each of these stores identified with a store number value. Spark lines are useful for examining and comparing trends. Here we see purchase amounts at each store trending over time. Calculated values can reflect an aggregation or the result of a custom expression. And rules can be applied in order to conditionally change font type or color. Note that these average purchase values are flagged with a red font when they dip below a threshold of $475. Icons are useful when actual values are not as important as the flags themselves. These icon alerts are the result of high or low customer purchase amounts of specific sale items at each store. And bullet graphs can be added to measure the progress toward a goal or relate values to specific milestones. Here, each store has reward goals, which they are striving to achieve with select sale items. Let's take a closer look at the graphical table visualization in a configured demonstration example. Use Open File and navigate to the example with Interpreting Graphical Tables in the title. Click Open and agree to the terms and conditions of use. The visualizations in this analysis document are supported by two data tables. This data table contains only two columns, a list of 76 sales associates and their individual sales target values. The other data table has 19 columns and relates information about the orders for office supplies which were handled by those sales associates. If we proceed to the next page, this graphical table has been configured using values from both of those data tables. However, the larger data table serves as the primary data source for this visualization. The first thing to assess about a graphical table visualization is what variable defines the rows. In this example, each row represents a sales associate. Then, you will find that the columns in the graphical table will be one of four types: spark lines, calculated values, icons, or bullet graphs. The first column in this graphical table is a spark line. It has been configured to relate annual sales totals across the four-year period, defined by the range of order dates in the underlying data table, for each sales associate. The start point and end point for each spark line have also been displayed. In this example, those reflect the annual sales totals for 2011 and 2014, respectively. The next column is a calculated value. In this example, it displays the result of calculating the total profit divided by the total sales amount, or profit ratio, achieved by each sales associate. Two rules have been configured for this calculated value. If any of these calculations result in a ratio which is lower than 0.3, those values will be flagged with red italicized font. If the ratio is greater than or equal to 0.4, the values will be displayed in bold font. The next column in the graphical table is an icon. This icon has been configured with a rule which indicates that the sales associates with the top 10 profit totals should be identified with a gold star. And we can scroll down through the table in order to locate all 10 of those stars. Or, returning to the top of the table, we could click to sort the table based upon the top 10 profit values, first in ascending order, and click a second time to sort them in descending order, such that the top 10 rows with gold stars appear at the top. A third click will return the graphical table to its original sort order. The next column is also an icon, but this one uses two rules which indicate whether a sales associate has breached certain threshold values for the average discount applied to their sales. An upward-facing green arrow indicates that the sales associate has a high average discount percentage, and a downward-facing red arrow indicates that the sales associate has a low average percentage discount. The final column in this graphical table is a bullet graph. This element of the visualization relies upon both of the underlying data tables. The primary data table is responsible for the length of the black bar, which reflects the total sales amount for each associate, and the position of the yellow line, which indicates the total profit achieved by those sales. The blue range, however, is based upon the smaller data table, which, you may recall, contained each associate's sales target. Therefore, we can compare the length of the black bar to the blue color range in order to determine which associates have met, have not met, or have exceeded their sales targets. On the next page, additional graphical tables have been configured. This graphical table uses two columns to define the rows, such that a hierarchy is created. Consequently, the spark lines displayed relate the average quarterly sales trends for each market segment within each region. And you can see that on this occasion, the start point and end points for each spark line are not displayed. This graphical table was configured without any variables assigned to define the rows. Therefore, the calculated value, which displays the total profit amount, reflects all of the profit values in the underlying data table. That is, at least until some filtering is performed. Note that as we use this list box filter to select the first sales associate's name and subsequently use the down arrow key on our keyboard to toggle through the list of names, which limits the data viewed to one associate at a time, you can see the value in the total profit cell changes. In addition, you can see the impact on the three other graphical tables on this page, which have been configured to relate a stoplight view of these total profit values. Each of these three graphical tables were configured without a column to define separate rows, resulting in a single circle icon which changes color based upon specific rules. The icon in the bottom graphical table will change to a bright green color when the total profit is above $75,000. The icon in the top graphical table will change to a bright red color when the total profit is below $40,000. And the middle graphical table will change to a yellow color whenever the total profit amount is between $40,000 and $75,000. Finally, it should be noted that the axis selectors and title bars have been hidden on each of these three visualizations in order to give a cleaner look to this approximation of a dashboard stoplight view.